Hey, I'm delighted to see your family here again, and I hope they feel that very special sense of pride in you. I'm sure they do. And I think, you know, I was thinking of my children and grandchildren, and this is really a once-in-a-lifetime occasion. So I hope they find it very special in their lives.
Thank you, Senator.
You're welcome.
Welcome back, everyone. On Monday, California Senator Dianne Feinstein announced that she will step down as the top Democrat on the Senate Judiciary Committee in next year's Congress. The news coming after Feinstein faced harsh blowback from progressives for her handling of Amy Coney Barrett's Supreme Court confirmation hearing. Apparently, Feinstein showed too much decency to Coney Barrett for the far left's liking. For more on this, we welcome in the former head of the California GOP, Tom Del Baccaro. He is also the author of The Divided Era. Welcome, Tom. So Feinstein pulled her punches because she was the one who originally attacked Amy Coney Barrett's Catholicism. She probably took her foot off the gas a little bit. And now they're making her pay the price for not causing a spectacle and turning the confirmation hearing into more of a circus than it was already. What do you make of all this?
Well, if you're on the left, it's not enough just to vote the right way. You've got to be a warrior. You've got to go all out with these people. And that's, you know, that's what the run-up to socialism looks like among socialists. They are fighters, and they don't take to kindly to civility. So she has to move aside for the more urgent, which is too bad because she is old school to a certain degree. But this is, as the parties get farther and farther apart and our divided era grows, she's a casualty of it.
Yeah, and she made Amy Coney Barrett. You know, I've had so many people tell me nobody would have ever heard of Amy Coney Barrett if Feinstein hadn't pushed so hard against her Catholicism, and her personal pro-life position, so she created a superstar, and they're going to make her pay for it. Biden is filling out his potential cabinet. Senator Marco Rubio today said that many of these appointments will manage America's decline. You've heard some of the names. What are your thoughts so far?
Well, it's a hard move to the left, even if it doesn't satisfy AOC. I mean, putting John Kerry in charge of anything is a dangerous precedent. Kerry, of course, wants to refund Iran, put them back on the international stage. He'd be the czar of climate change energy in America. So he will push for the decline of American independence and use of fossil fuels. At the same time, he wants to open up Iran's fossil fuel market. And when Iran has money, it foments terror in the Middle East and around the world. John Kerry's the worst of it. And to counterbalance, and that will, of course, hurt the American economy. To counterbalance that, we're looking at Janet Yellen at Treasury, who's probably a bit understated, right? I don't think we've had a populist Secretary of Treasury since Hamilton under way back when. But they're absolutely going to use quantitative easing again, because on the one hand, he wants to harm the economy. So he wants the Fed to float all the damage that would be done.
Right. Look, it just seems that you've got a bunch of Obama administration retreads. It seems that President Obama is already having a tremendous amount of influence on all of this. And when it comes to foreign policy and economic policy, I mean, you go back to wage stagnation, you go back to outsourcing of jobs, foreign policy. The Obama foreign policy was one of the most disastrous in the modern era. And I love John Kerry. John Kerry is going to be the climate czar, and it's almost like they wanted to give him something. They're still trying to pay him back for running and losing in 2004, and so they're going to give him a little something to do. But you know, this is a guy that people should be concerned about because he doesn't care. He's a multimillionaire. He's got his wife's, you know, the Heinz ketchup money. So if you lose your job because he wants to go back into the Paris Climate Accord, or he wants to be an internationalist and let the UN make our decisions on how we're going to run our economy, it doesn't really impact him. a whole heck of a lot.
And it's just like Gavin Newsom out here. He's rich. He can shut things down, and he lives the high life, as we know.
Yeah. One more thing before we get to Gavin Newsom, but none of these people that Biden is talking about have any history of being really forceful and really serious about pushing back against China. And China is our biggest geostrategic threat right now. And all of these folks, whether it's Iran, whether it's China, whether it's Russia, end up going back to an appeasement strategy. So look, I want to talk about LA. LA has issued a 3-week stay-at-home order due to rising coronavirus cases. They also flipped their position on outdoor dining on restaurants right before Thanksgiving, which is just awful. Why do you still live there, man?
Sadly, I started a law firm here, and it's harder for me to leave. But you know, this is another nail in the coffin to small business. They were surviving on outdoor crowds and people come to their restaurants. They've killed that off. It was bad enough winter wise. I don't know how these people in particular. I'm blessed. I can work from home and use computers. But restaurants can't do that. It's one of the reasons I started rescuecalifornia.org to put the recall over the finish line.
All right. Well, we're all pulling for you on that. Tom Del Beccaro, thank you very much for being with us. Appreciate it. And have a happy Thanksgiving.
All right. Good to see you again. You too.
You just watched Newsmax TV, America's fastest growing cable news channel, now in more than 70 million homes. You can get Newsmax TV on your cable system or check your cable guide. And if your system doesn't carry Newsmax, call them, tell them you want Newsmax TV, because we're real news for real people.